principal of West Broadway Elementary School, and I'd just like to take this time to welcome all of our parents, our visitors, our guardians. We're glad to have you with us today for this very special program. Before we get started, I'd just like to say a few words to the parents, to the fifth grade class. I'd just like to say to the parents to thank you all for letting us work with your children. It's a very, very serious task for you to take your children and send them off to school and send them off to areas where you're not going to be and trust them in somebody else's care. And we appreciate the idea that you let us do that. We're grateful about that. Also, when we talk about West Broadway Elementary School, when we talk about the fifth grade class moving on, I like to say that when we talk about that, in theory, what I hope to do, since I've been here and we talked to our teachers about it, what we hope to do is that we don't really have to concentrate on grades all the time. It's not all about science and math and reading all the time. The most important thing that we try to achieve here at West Broadway, and if you achieve these things, the other things will come. And the whole process, you got to see it as a philosophy, as a process, as a system, so to speak. When these fifth graders leave here, we don't only want to recognize them for their academic awards that will come, but we want to leave them with a new way of thinking, a new way of feeling, and a new way of acting that gives them a peace within their own individuality and their own individualism. We try to accomplish that, and we hope that when they leave, they have gained respect from people that are unlike them. And they should have gained wisdom to discern and understand human beings, other people, other cultures, and other traditions. And most importantly, they should have developed a sense of courage and the ability to act on them. At this time, they're moving a little deeper into their lives. They're stronger, they're wiser, they're smarter. And they're moving, they've been called to move deeper into their lives. And my advice to you is that don't avoid doing something for fear of making a mistake. Falling down does not make you a failure, but staying down does. Failure often comes from the lack of determination rather than the lack of talent. And remember, our main objective here in West Broadway is to develop plans, strategies, and plans to give you a hope for your future. And we pray that you are put on a path in your life where there are new days ahead of you, filled with new chances, filled with new opportunities. You see, some people succeed because they are destined to, but most people succeed because they are determined to. The future belongs to those who believe in their dreams. A wise man once said that the poorest of all men is not a man without a cent, but a man without a dream. And sooner or later, fifth graders, your time will be your own. Your time will be your own. And should use it wisely. Use it wisely, for you will never pass this way again. You'll never pass this way again. Ladies and gentlemen, meet our fifth grade class of 2020. At this time, Deeper by Marvin Sapp.
Charles and Marty is calling me deeper, deeper, breaks everything and removes all my fears. He's calling me deeper, deeper, to see the place that I'm
Hope you enjoy that video. At this time, I'm going to introduce our fourth grade teachers first, Ms. Pendley. She didn't know I'm getting ready to change you around. Sorry. Miss Walker, you want to come up? Whoever's going to go first, fourth grade. I don't know who's going first. Sorry about that, Miss Pendley.
I'm going to award the fourth grade reading award. I have two perfect attendance awards, Michael Powell. Ryan Chandler. In Ms. Odom's room, we have Trenton Bryant. McKaylee Scott. We have two spelling bee winners, and we just want you to stand up and be recognized. Devin Richardson and Harmony Pates.
We also had a fifth grade math team. We went to the community college and competed. If you would stand up, please. Lily Moore, Harmony Cates, Emmy Faisenbaker, Joey Porter. There's one more. Where are you? Ainsley Golden. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Who was, raise your hand if you were top in the school. Emmy Faisenbaker. Give her a round of applause.
Okay, school counts is 2 or less days absent. So come down, we have a medal for you. This is from the community college. Alexis Hutchinson. Josie Minser. Justin Morgan. Joseph Mullins. Hillary Oldwin. Joey Porter. Michael Powell. Corey Ramage. McKaylee Scott. Ashley Wheeler. Sheridan White. And Nick Zachary. Oh, Now, I don't know about you, but I know how hard it is to get up every day and come to school, so only missing 2 days or less. Let's give them all if we can.
We had one student that fit that description, and not only does she fit that description, she also did not have any checks on her back sheet all year long. So this award is called Gold for the Gold, and she's receiving it because she had all A's her whole fifth grade year and no checks her whole fifth grade year. Emmy Fazenbaker. Okay, moving on to math awards, or all the academic awards. We will be giving the top three students, fifth grade, in all the academic areas. Starting with math, I have Emmy Fazenbaker, Lily Moore, Joe O'Reilly. Okay, for spelling, Emmy Fazenbaker, Ainsley Golden, and Josie Mincer. Language arts, Emmy Fazenbaker, Ainsley Golden, Justin Morgan.
Studies Award go to Emmy Fazenbaker, Lily Moore, Josie Mincer. Okay, we move on to science. We have Matt Lacebrook. Josie Mincer. And Lily Moore. The Reading Award is awarded on AR points. In third place, with 87.4, Ainsley Golden. With 186.5, Kaylee Tucker. And 235.9, Lily Moore. Doing.
All right, now it's time for the Physical Education Awards. For Ms. Odom's class, the physical education award goes to Trenton Bryant. In Ms. Penley's class, it goes to Joseph Mullins. And in Ms. Vaughn's class, it goes to Dylan Nance.
Library awards are based on interest in coming into the library, how they behave, whether or not they are very helpful. I think you probably all have figured out by now that Lily Moore is one of those, since she had all those AR points. Come on down, Lily. Lauren Grable. And Taylor Binkley. Now we are going to do all the students who had all A's and B's all year, and it's called the Teacher's Honor Roll. Harmony Cates. Ainsley Golden. Lily Moore. Justin Morgan. Joey Porter. And McKaylee Scott. And we have one student that had all A's all year, Emmy Faisenbaker.
Academic team awards today. These are students who tried out for the academic team in November. There were probably about 55 students that tried out for 14 spots, and they practiced twice a week, did lots of studying at home. Most of this is on their own, and we competed in a district competition and a regional competition. So I'm going to call them up for recognition of their district competition first. And then those that advance the region, I'll call their names, and they'll take a step forward for second recognition in that. Okay? Will Curtis. Abby Dixon. Gabe Edwards. Ella Farmer. Emmy Faisenbaker. Vera Fisher. Ainsley Golden. Lauren Grable. Lily Moore. Justin Morgan. Madison Nagy. Devin Richardson. Maddie Tao. And Nick Zachary. While Nick's making his way down, I'll go ahead and let you guys know. It kind of feels like every year I say how proud I am of these guys and how great of a job they did, but they never cease to amaze me. They surprise me every year, they do a great job every year, and they seem to just continue to exceed each other. So the next students that I'll recognize were ones that advance from the region. In order to do that, you have to score in the top five of your content area or first or second in your team event. So I'll call those out for you and they'll step forward and Ms. Hancock will give you that certificate as well. In mathematics, we had Lily Moore placing first place. Amy Faisenbecker placing second. And Gabe Edwards placing third. And guys, if you'll just stay out there so she can see you. In social studies, we had Lily Moore placing second. And Will Curtis placing fourth. In language arts, Abby Dixon placed second. In science, Gabe Edwards placed first. Ella Farmer placed fourth. Ainsley Golden placed fifth. In writing composition, Emmy Faisenbaker placed third. And Maddie Tao placed fourth. Arts and humanities, Vera Fisher placed third. And Devin Richardson tied with her for third as well. Our FPS team, even though they didn't advance, they did just barely miss it and they placed third place. Our quick recall team did place second. So if you were on quick recall and you haven't stepped up, which is Justin Morgan, and we got second place overall, they did a really great job. At the region, they competed against 20 other schools. Lily Moore received recognition for mathematics, placing 24 correct out of 30 or higher. Abby Dixon placed fifth in language arts, and Emmy Faisenbecker placed fourth in composition, and Vera Fisher placed third in arts and humanities. They did a great job. Give them a round of applause.
Scored, made the highest score of distinguished. Some of them scored distinguished in reading, some of them scored distinguished in math, and some of them scored distinguished in both areas. So, and guys, do you want them to stay? Just make a row as we call your name, just like we do in the mornings. Savannah Adams, distinguished in reading. Cheyenne Avery, distinguished in reading and math. Hunter Brown, distinguished in math. Skylar Kanan, distinguished in reading and math. Noah Cook, distinguished in math. Craig Cunningham, distinguished in reading and math. Abby Dixon, distinguished in reading and math. Gabe Edwards, distinguished in math. Ian Ellis, distinguished in reading and math. Ella Farmer, distinguished in reading and math. Ethan Finch, distinguished in math. Vera Fisher, distinguished in math.
Josh Force, distinguished in math. And Kaylee Tucker, reading, math, and science. Big round of applause for all these boys and girls.
Furry Feisenbaker. Jenna Fitzgerald. Joshua Ford. Caitlin Gibson. Matt Glazebrook.
For your life, you are sure. Oh,